Hi everyone. Thank you for inviting me to this event. At first I was a little confused why I was being invited to an event with this kind of topic. And last night when I was telling my mum about it, she actually made me stop and think when she asked me who my hero was. And I thought for a little while and I said, Spider-Man. To which she said, Spider-Man's not real. And at that point I just hung up on her. But it's true, it's Spider-Man. And it's Spider-Man because he's kind of the only superhero that makes mistakes. Just throughout the comic books, there are just references to him doing silly things and messing up and taking on a responsibility that isn't his. And I love that. I love that he's not a professional, unlike me, who's written their speech notes on their plane ticket from yesterday. Like such a professional. But yeah, so I guess when you think ocean conservationist, you probably imagine a marine biologist in one of those fancy Kathmandu hats tagging sharks offshore. That's the complete opposite of me. I am here today basically because some of us don't choose a heroic path, which I think someone already said in their speech. And very much so in my case, I was thrown into one involuntarily. So this was me when I was 12 years old. And those big fish around me are my family. That's who I was raised with. I was diving with sharks my entire life. And that was my home, and I loved it, and it was everything to me. And that lifestyle quickly changed when at age 14 I went back to those reefs and didn't see any sharks. That is when the little switch flipped in my brain. And then at 14 I actually left school and began homeschooling and made an agreement with my dad that we would trade school fees and I could get an underwater video camera, which was awesome. And I was gonna make sick documentaries and I was gonna be on the Discovery Channel and my life was gonna be sweet. And that's what my life turned out to be. The most important thing to me now is documenting the injustices. And I think we really need to change our perception of what a hero is in the ocean conservation world. Because I'm not a marine biologist. I'm a high school dropout. I've been referred to as a delinquent. I've been in trouble multiple times. Never finished school. Still live with my grandparents. But we need to change our idea of heroism because our planet is changing. And it's changing really fast. And I believe, I guess I'm kind of a representation of how the necessity of my generation to fight for the planet and how desperate and sad things are getting that I've seen a change in my lifetime at 22 years old. I didn't want to be doing this kind of stuff. I wanted to be diving with sharks. But instead, I found myself fighting for them. And I put this clip in here, which I shot a few weeks ago, actually, in the Bahamas with a film crew from Channel 7 who were terrified of diving with sharks. It was hilarious. They were so scared before getting in the water. But this is the animal that I have to try and save. Look at that thing. Nobody wants to save that thing, especially in Australia. Nobody wants me to stand up and say, they're not that bad. They occasionally take people. Nobody wants to save that animal. So I had two challenges. Not just save sharks, but make other people want to save sharks, and that's really difficult. The reality is there's an average of one death from sharks in Australia each year, and each year worldwide we kill more than 100 million sharks, and that's the reality of it. And yes, they're big and scary and dangerous, absolutely, but that doesn't mean we should be ignoring them. So as a shark conservationist, you face a few challenges. And yeah, so tiger sharks. Most recently in Western Australia during the shark cull, this was a time where heroic acts were really showing up. On the boat with me this day, when we got in trouble from fisheries for grabbing this tiger shark, there was a mother of two who was literally just a housewife and a woman that washed dogs for a living, had one of those little mobile pet grooming vans, and every single one of them on that day was a hero. Because when we got back to shore, fisheries came up to us and they tried to charge us with possession of a protected species. And then when we refused to give them our footage, they threatened to take us to court for obstruction of justice. And then a week later, the footage was on YouTube, because that's how we work. Everybody that day was a hero. So they all got thrust into a situation where they had to be brave. And we did. We broke laws to document that kind of stuff. And the other big thing is shark meat. That's these are like little, I guess, success stories of what I've been doing. So shark meat's everywhere in Australia. And it's been really difficult for me to stand up and go, can everybody please stop eating shark? Because most people don't even know about it, so trying to affect the trade has been really difficult. But there are some success stories. Actually, just this morning, I wasn't here because I said, Matt, I've got to go. And he's like, okay, go. And I went into Melbourne and went to a fish and chip shop with a friend of mine based in Melbourne, who we took some shark meat from them about a year ago and had it tested. And there were some problems with mercury and arsenic in it, and it was an unsustainable species. So just this morning we went and spoke to them, and they didn't want us there. They didn't like us there. And customers were like abusing us as we were talking to them and they were walking past. And I was like, you're speaking at a heroism concert, just be heroic, just think of Spider-Man. And we did, and they calmed down a little bit, and I got an email from them a few minutes ago saying that they're gonna take shark off the shelves. So, yay! Thank you for letting me run away for that one, Matt, and sneak that one in with my flights. This was the hardest thing for me. I'm actually a pretty shy person. I don't really like humans. I don't do a lot of public speaking, in case you couldn't tell, and I don't like interacting with humans because I like sharks. But we did this kind of stuff recently. This was in Brisbane City, and that's a real baby bull shark, and I sat in the main street of Brisbane so people could walk past and see it and stop and read the information. And the information was about shark meat being toxic and about baby sharks being the ones that are targeted in fisheries. So that required a lot of bravery to do something like that. Projecting footage in a lot of places is another thing that I've done a lot of, which is great because people get to see what's happening, people that would otherwise probably never see what's happening. My documentary, Shark Girl, was like a really big thing for me. When you're 14 years old and you care about something, it's really hard to get your message across. No one wants to listen to a 14-year-old girl. And maybe if I was saving dolphins or something cute, but not only saving sharks, no one wants to listen. So I had to find a medium that would work. So I found filmmaking. What happened on the Great Barrier Reef was a tragedy that I had to overcome. And I could have gone, I'll just go overseas and dive with sharks. And I could have done that and I could have had a happy life, but instead I said, no, I'm going to stay here and I'm going to fight it. And I had to change and I had to do stuff. So I started making little films, and that eventually turned into my documentary, which has had great success. So that was a wonderful thing. And school talks, teaching young kids about sharks, how to be safe about sharks, the truth about sharks, things like that, that have been really helpful. That's my favourite picture ever of a shark selfie. And I got photobombed by a shark during a photo. That was great. But yeah, I got asked the difficult question of how are you going to relate sharks to heroism in this speech? So I spent the last couple days figuring out how am I. The truth is, sharks are the underdogs. And usually the heroes start out by being the underdogs. They are so essential to our oceans and so amazing and so nowhere near as evil as we think when they're not like the plastic shark out of Jaws. And it's just funny to relate them. It's not me that's the hero, it's sharks. I mean, yes, they occasionally eat people, but they are the important underdogs. So they are my heroes anyway. Seeing as I have a few minutes left, I'm gonna play a short little film with just a little bit of footage that I actually made for another conference. Don't be mad, Matt. But the idea of that conference was to rise up and do something, which I guess relates a lot to this conference as well. So, tech guy, we spoke about this, all good. I'm just gonna leave you with some footage that I started shooting from age 14 up until now. And yeah, thank you.
The Hero Roundtables are the global events that ask the question, what is a hero? You've just seen one hero talk. To find more and join the conversation, visit our website or social media.